Hello students, let's continue the class on types of personality. And so we will be dealing about Hippocrates classification today. So as we all know that Hippocrates, a Greek philosopher, a great physician who is considered as one of the outstanding figures in the field of medicine, right? So today we will be dealing about his classification. And you know that his types of personality is based on body fluids or body temperaments, what we can call. And he has divided the body temperaments into four types, and they are called to be choleric kind of personality, melancholic kind of personality, phlegmatic personality, and sanguine personality. So choleric temperament, we are having yellow bile, that is from liver, right? And we are having melancholic personality, that is from black bile, which is from kidneys. And we are having phlegmatic personality, the phlegm, which is from lungs. And also the sanguine personality, the red blood, which is from the heart. So these are the four types of personality what we speak about today. And he says that all these body temperaments decides the behavior of the individual. The first type of personality called to be a choleric kind of personality. So as I already told you that it is a yellow bile what we talk about. So people who are having this choleric personality are having few characteristics, and the characteristics goes like this. These are the people who are highly active, and they get easily angered, irritable most of the times, and these are the people who are having emotionally weak but bodily completely strong. So one quality is negative and one quality is positive. So the negative quality is emotionally they are completely weak, but however bodily they are completely strong, so that could be the positive quality. So the sign what we use for this is minus plus. And the element of this choleric personality we compare to the fire. So fire is the element which will be compared to the people who are into choleric personality. So minus plus, emotionally weak but bodily strong, called to be the part of choleric personality, which they have yellow bile. Yeah, the second factor of personality what he has spoken about is the melancholic personality. So melancholic personality, the body temperament which is from liver is the black bile. So these are the people who are having no energy and no happiness. So both the quality of personality is completely negative. Very bad tempered people, most of the time they are into depression, so depressed kind, and pessimistic in nature. So the signs what we use here is minus and minus, because they are emotionally as well as bodily weak. So minus minus personality is melancholic personality. The element which is compared to this personality is earth. Well, the third type of personality what we talk about is phlegmatic personality. So these are the people who are having thick phlegm from the lungs. So the white phlegm which is generated from the lungs, and the lungs usually will be have colorless, and it is a thick phlegm. And these are the people with the quality who are happy but lazy. So one positive quality and one negative quality we could see. However, these are the people who are opposite of choleric personality. These people are emotionally strong. So if there is one positive quality but bodily very weak. So emotionally strong and bodily weak, so it is plus and minus. So one positive quality and one negative quality. The element of phlegmatic personality is compared to water. So this is one of the types of Hippocrates. Well, the last part of the quality of personality, the behavior, is compared to the phlegmatic. After phlegmatic, we are having sanguine personality. So you know that sanguine are the people who are having high energy, much energetic, right? They are confident. These are the people who are having the body temperament of excessive blood. So you know the people who are young, energetic, very cheerful, very optimistic in nature. So you had seen pessimistic attitude in terms of melancholic personality, whereas these are the people who are quite opposite of it. So these are the people who are very much optimistic in nature, very positive and confident. So the quality goes with positive plus positive. So these are the people who are bodily strong as well as emotionally strong. So plus and plus quality. So these are the people who are compared to air. So air, the speed what is gauged, what can be seen here as these are the people who are energetic, very confident, and as well as cheerful. So these are the four types of qualities what we can talk about. The first quality is choleric, which is of yellow bile, and it is minus and plus, emotionally very strong but emotionally weak but bodily very strong. And the second one, we know that it is a quality in terms of melancholy, right? So very sad. They are having no energy, very negative in nature. And the third quality is phlegm. So these are the people who are emotionally very strong but bodily very weak. And the fourth quality are the people who are having sanguine blood, excessive blood. So these are the people who are energetic, confident and cheerful in nature. So it goes with plus quality. Let's move on to the second major type of classification what we can talk about, and the classification which is given by Kretschmer. So his classification is based on body structure of the individual, and body structure of the individual decides the behavior of the individual. So he has categorized the body type of body structure of the individual towards the classification, and it comprises of the four types of personality: pyknic personality, athletic personality, leptosomatic personality, which is also called to be asthenic personality, as well as the dysplastic personality. Well, let's talk something about the pyknic personality people. These are the people who are having fat bodies. So the physical type would be very much plumpy in nature. So these are the people who are having tendency to put on weight. And the personality character of the people is they are much sociable, jolly, easygoing, good-natured and extrovert kind of people. So generally, you know, they interact with people very easygoing, very friendly in nature. But however, they are having a tendency to put on weight, having fat bodies, and so called to be pyknic personality. And the second factor of Kretschmer's classification is athletic personality. And you know that people who belong to the athletic group are always balanced body, right? So balanced bodied people, the personality character would be very much energetic, and they are also optimistic as well as adjustable to any sort of situation. So adjustive nature, people with much energy and people who are positive in terms of thinking are the factors what can be contributed in the field of athletic personality. The third kind of personality what we talk is the leptosomatic personality, which is also called to be the asthenic personality. And you know, these are the people who are very much lean, they are also thin, right? The personality character of these people would be unsociable. So these are the people who are not friendly like your pyknic personality, and a very introvert kind of personality, reserved in nature. They never communicate to people in an easy way, and very shy natured, sensitive to the adjustive factors, and most of the time they are pessimistic in nature, and they tend to have autistic and introvert personality. So it is not easy for them to communicate with the society people, and so called they are to be the leptosomatic or asthenic personality. And the fourth type of personality which is given by Kretschmer is the dysplastic personality. And these are the people who are very much ill-balanced, and the physical structure of the personality of such people is we could see that they are underdeveloped in their body. So the physical body of the people are underdeveloped. And when we talk something about the personality character, it's a mixture of the first three types. So you know, the pyknic personality, sometimes they will be jovial, social, easygoing, and it is also a mixture of athletic personality, right? Energetic and optimistic, and also kind of asthenic personality, right? They are not so adjustable towards the nature or the society. So this is what we can talk something about the Kretschmer's classification. Let's also discuss about the third type of classification what we can talk about, that is Eysenck's classification. So you can see the right side of the PPT, right? So that is Eysenck who has given his own classification based on the nature of people. And his classification is classified into extroversion, introversion, and the people who come in between are called as ambiverts or ambiversion. So who are these people, introvert? So you can just look at the slide. So there are two people with the same sentence, but one we could see optimistic in nature, very positive. I'm staying in tonight, right? And the right side, you can see one more picture who is very much sad. I'm staying in tonight. So I'm staying away from home. So I'm not happy. So one picture tells that he is happy, and the other picture tells that he is not happy. So the first picture talks about the extroversion. So people are very adjustive in nature. Wherever you go, when you go to parties, you feel that, you know, you feel the home environment. You see to it that you are very friendly with the people. and you are not shy natured, you can mingle with the people. But whereas